Hey y'all, it's All of Destiny. In this video, I'll be sharing with you all my current nighttime routine for 2020. I start off by playing relaxing music. Sometimes I'll use relaxation radio on Pandora, or I'll just search relaxing music on YouTube. Whenever I'm in the restroom like this, I consider that me time. That's why I'm the only person that's in the room. So no text messages will be replied to or phone calls. Don't scroll social media. Just play relaxing music, light your candles. This is a great way to help prepare the brain to know that it's going to be sleeping time soon. Since my gym is currently closed, I don't have a designated time that I work out, but I am trying to work out daily. I did this particular day work out towards the evening, so I want to go ahead and shower first before I continue with the rest of my routine. Tie my braids down with this braid bonnet that I picked up at the beauty supply store. All items will be linked in the description box down below. What better way to relax than with a soothing bubble bath at the end of the day? And not only will this give you a mental escape, but it helps to nourish your skin along the way. In my bubble bath tonight, I'll be adding some of the Dr. Till's foaming bath. I'm also adding in some of the Epsom salt as well. The directions call for 2 cups. I'm just going to eyeball mine though. And then I'm also adding some of the cow gum moisturizing bath beads. And then I'm just going to add in a cap full of this bath salt to the water as well. The directions call for 2 to 4 teaspoons, so I guess that's kind of equivalent. No disclaimers will be given about my bubble bath, but I will say this. I've seen people add more sugar to Kool-Aid than the amount of products that I just added to this larger amount of water, and we'll leave it there. Your soaking time will depend on whichever products you've added to the water. I always just follow the directions provided on the products that I've used. After my bubble bath, I don't just get out and pat dry. I follow up with a shower every time, but I don't do bubble baths nightly, if that makes sense. I like to exfoliate while I'm in the shower. Tonight, I'm using the Tree Hut Shea Sugar Scrub. I recently picked this one up since running out of the Tree Hut Firming one, which I absolutely loved, and I like this one too. This helps to remove dead skin, which definitely comes in handy, especially if you're planning to shave. And speaking of shaving, I like to do what I call Shave Saturdays. The name is sort of catchy, so it helps me to also remember when I shaved last and when I should follow up with shaving again, unless it's an area of the body that, you know, needs a little more attention, like the armpits. But who has enough voiceover space to squeeze in all of those small points? And if you're wondering what I do in the shower, I use a towel, sometimes a loofah, but most times a towel for the original wash. That second follow-up, I might use my loofah. I use soap. They got lots of different options, sis. We got Caress, we got Dove, we got Dial, Olay, take your pick. And I also use the feminine wash and my hands. But we know she's self-cleaning, but she needs help, sis. Just remember, external use only. I like to use this thing, which is really for the face. Never tried it out, but it works great on the armpits. And before you get out, you want to go ahead and apply some oil to the skin before you pat dry. It really locks in the moisture. Since you like to be clean, don't disrespect your shower. She likes to be clean too. Spray her down, wash her off, rinse her off, make sure she's clean. And I do realize my little shower portion was super short, but I'm going to do a separate shower routine for you guys as soon as I figure out how to appropriately film one for you all. Especially because I read a comment once where someone said that you shouldn't shower twice. And I was like, yes, you should. Morning and night. Hopefully that routine will be coming soon. It's time for skincare. Skincare is something that I do morning and night. I do have a detailed skincare routine on my channel, which will be linked in the description box down below. I'm still getting lots of DMs and questions and concerns about skincare. Help me out and tell a friend that I do have a skincare routine on my channel with all of the products linked in the description box down below. I'm going to use my alcohol to wipe down my face, especially during this time. If I don't use my alcohol, then I just follow up with witch hazel. I also like to use alcohol to cleanse anything that may touch my face, including my glasses, since why bother putting my contacts in at this time? Or my cell phone, because think about it. After you shower up, you get settled, you get situated, you lay down on the phone, you put the phone on your face so that you don't have to hold it, and you just probably laid it around everywhere. So even before quarantine things, baby, we cleanse that phone off nightly, okay? Just gonna pour the remainder of that into my little pump. Again, all links are in the description box down below. Proceed to moisturize. I know it looks like I'm only doing my arms here, but you know, hello, sort of family channel. Trying to keep it, you know, classy, keep it clean, but put that lotion everywhere, sis. We don't want to be dry. Now, it's tea time. Tea time. Amanda, please. No, I'm kidding. We got options, sis. We got options. The options are on the shelf at Kroger, if you're wondering where I got these from. and also how to make your own little, you know, cute little tea display. And that video will be linked down below. Sometimes I mix two that probably shouldn't be mixed, but you know, hey, let's try it and see what we get. I used to do that in chemistry lab. Just pour everything into one bin and see what happens. No, I'm kidding. My lab partner used to do that. But I'm gonna do 1 teaspoon of sugar. Definitely do honey if you like. Allow that to cool down a little bit, and I lounge around, light my candles. I watch YouTube videos. Sometimes I might watch Netflix. You guys should be watching more of my YouTube videos than Netflix. I'm just saying, I got 600 plus uploads that you all should check out. But either way, this is the eucalyptus oil from Better Homes, along with the diffuser. Links to both will be in the description box down below. Sometimes if I leave my water sitting too long and I feel like I can't even remember if it's mine, instead of wasting it, I use it to water my plant or to fill my diffuser. Don't judge me. After a while of lounging, watching YouTube videos, it's time to eat. My sister prepared something. It was really good. I'll ask her what this was, and if I can link food, I'll link that in the description box down below too. And now, let us pray. And now, we feast! Not necessarily back to back in Drake's voice, but still lounging, so of course I want a pre-bedtime snack. Quarantine things. Should we reach for fruit? Should we reach for cookies? And by the way, Chips Ahoy over Oreos. And don't at me, but follow me on Instagram. But randomly, in the spare of the moment filming this video, I was like, ooh, I got the reduced fat packaging and the regular one at the same time. I started comparing the nutritional facts and found out there's only a 10 calorie difference between the two, and also that the reduced fat one has more carbs. Interesting. Very interesting. But either way, I didn't even have cookies that night. I was just debating. I ended up having bubble fruit and Yoplait yogurt with granola. And now it's time for Face Mask Fridays. Even though I don't do a mask every Friday, but that's a catchy way to remember it if you want to consistently start adding this to your routine. It's a do-it-yourself powder. It's a clay mask, so it comes with everything that you need. You want to basically dump out the contents into the little bowl that you get. As a matter of fact, where is the professional packaging so I can sound professional over here? So yeah, you want to open the paper bowl found inside and open the powder sachet and pour the powder and the bowl. Then you want to add the water to the fill line and mix it to create the clay mask. To customize the mask, you can add in other ingredients. On the back, it says yogurt, honey, banana, aloe vera gel, avocado, or green tea. I think I'm just gonna stick with the mask. I don't want to mix up anything extra. So I'm gonna use this little tool that I remember purchasing from Dollar Tree when I saw this in there, because I didn't really like the one that was provided in the kit. I guess you could also use your hands, but then again, you could also use a, you know, old but clean foundation brush to do this as well, because, you know, bougie quarantine vibes. Continuing to follow the instructions on all of my packaging, it says to relax for 10 minutes or 20 for an even deeper treatment. So of course, that's what I opted for, because it means that I get to watch YouTube videos longer. Also, shout out to my little sister Bone for the Netflix password. Yes, sir. Time to wash off the mask. The instructions say you can use a damp face cloth and then rinse with warm water, but I always just go straight in with warm water to rinse off my masks. A quick little reminder again, my skincare routine video is linked in my description box down below. Very affordable products. I think I only use I use all drugstore stuff. Like, if you don't take away anything from my channel, take away keep it simple. And also, most times, it's not what you use, it's that you're consistent with using it. So, speaking of being consistent, I'm trying to get into the habit of really applying an oil to my brows and lashes each night. Sometimes I use oil to remove excess mascara, but in this time, I haven't really been applying makeup, because why? I'm not going anywhere. But also, as far as brushing my teeth, I do that every single night. Every night, every morning, 2 minutes. If you have an electric toothbrush, don't just like hold it and move it around just because you think it's electric. You're still supposed to like brush, sis, brush. And of course, follow up with swish swish, 30 seconds. So the last thing I'm going to go ahead and do before I get settled for bed is just to do a little bit of cleaning up. And in this case, it's the dishes. I feel like I have a better fresh start to a new day when I don't leave behind yesterday's tasks. And in this case, that's the dishes. Plus, this gives me an extra opportunity to watch another YouTube video. Multitasking at its best. Once I finish washing all of the dishes, I basically give them all one good rinse together. This helps to get all of the bubbles in the soap and stuff off of them while they dry. Sort of like the same thing with the bubble bath and then taking the shower afterwards. I try not to get into my bed until I'm really close to my actual falling asleep time, which for me, I don't really have a consistent one right now. That's what I'm working on. The more time that you spend in bed before you sleep, the more that your body gets used to being awake in your bed. Every blue moon, I might actually turn on my TV and watch, you know, cable, but most times I'm usually just on my laptop watching YouTube videos or editing some content. But I think I might purchase like the LaRue cool box so that I can at least access YouTube in my bedroom without using my laptop all the time. Each night is different, obviously, but more or less, this is what my nighttime routine consists of. I hope you all have enjoyed this video. Oh, before I forget, if you're still here, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel because it's absolutely free to do so. If you like routine videos like this one, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. That way I will know you all want to see more content like this from me. Other than that, I hope you all enjoyed this one. I probably already said that, but questions or comments, leave all of that down below. And as always, I thank you all so much for watching.